Yeah,
we've watched her for 9 years. 9 years.
Hey, we're here first.
Recorded.
We're here first.
Illegitimate. Let's get Lemigre here. Let's get Ice here, right? You got a problem with it? You got a business license? You got a license from the health department? No, you don't, do you? You know me. I haven't been in your face in a while.
You should be embarrassed.
They can't even.
You should be embarrassed. You should be embarrassed on yourself.
Real grown up.
A grown man acting like a little kid. Get out of here, bro.
Hey.
All right, Karenicity in this one runs deep. His actions were in fact criminal. He should have been arrested. Hopefully this video will create a sentiment of justice. This is once again the equivalent of demanding freedom papers. Do you have your business license from a person who has no authority to even request these things from a vendor? Are you approved by the health department? And then he goes on to his bigotry. And then he says, I haven't been in your face in a while, which indicates he has harassed this person before. So this activity is actually habitual. What you just saw, ladies and gentlemen, was an elderly white bigot who has been living on privilege for many decades. And when you are accustomed to privilege, as we say, equality looks like oppression. So why is it that this male Karen is so antithetical to a vendor that's in front of him? And why has this action been so continual? Well, he showed at the end, he really just wants to destroy things. He starts to destroy the property of this vendor. Let's put the picture up full mass here. All right, we're still trying to collect information on this particular male Karen. Seeing how this male Karen conducted himself in a criminal manner. All right, maybe an intervention is required. Okay, attorney, what are your thoughts here?
Well, you know, I definitely was automatically drawn to his LA hat, thinking he might be in Los Angeles, in part because, you know, Los Angeles is 48%, nearly 50% Hispanic. And the fact that you're targeting these individuals who are street vendors, like, that's just, it's like you're pretty much in the minority there. What are you doing? And on top of that, it's like this individual is clearly exercising their privilege to try to make other people feel unsafe and insecure, and as though that they will face some kind of punishment or sanction in some way just for existing and trying to do their business and to earn a living wage. It really just speaks to some of the hate that people bring with them when people are not bothering them, not doing anything, yet they will go out of their way to really just perpetuate this hatefulness, this disgusting nature that is truly a problematic aspect of our society. And we see that it will show up even when it is completely and totally unprovoked.
Very well said. All right.